So, if you're struggling with the basic concept of multigrid methods and have no clue what's going on, this video might be useful to you. Short disclaimer, I am a mechanical engineer and not a mathematician, and I pieced together this code only as a help for myself to understand what's happening. There might be some nonsense in there, but at least the basic concept should be somewhat correct. I couldn't find anything similar during my research, so I suppose in any case, something is better than nothing. Alright, let's get into multigrid method. Maybe the most important thing I've learned is that most iterative solvers are very good at capturing fine details of a curve, but very bad at capturing the big picture. As I understand it, what's happening in multigrid method is that instead of stubbornly running a whole bunch of iterations on the fine grid, we repeatedly coarsen it in between. This turns what has been the big picture of the fine grid into a much smaller system where this big picture now is the fine details, so it can be captured by iterative solvers much better. All this will become much clearer after seeing an actual example, so let's run this code a couple times until we get a nice looking system with some distinct features. Not a fan of that one. That's good. So, what are these curves? The very thick green line, you can see here, is the exact solution of the initial system. It's determined by the backslash operator, which is basically a more efficient version of the classic multiplication of b by the exact inverse of a. The thick blue line is our multigrid solution, and the thick red line we'll talk about a bit later. The thin turquoise lines you can see at the bottom are the solutions of the Jacobi methods on the different coarsening levels, and the thin bluish green line you can see here is a kind of intermediate multigrid solution that I added just for a better overview. So, let's start with the finest of the turquoise lines, which you can see here. This is the result of a single Jacobi iteration on the initial system with the zero vector as an initial guess. You see the structure of the tiny peaks and valleys of the exact solution is already quite well resolved, but the overall curve is way too low. So we coarsen the system and run another single Jacobi iteration on it, from this time on solving for the error instead of x itself, which is this curve. You can see the coarse system reacts much better to the overall shape of the exact solution, but obviously can't resolve the fine details. After that, we do a second coarsening step to pick up the overall shape even better, which is this curve. Then we are basically done. All we have left is adding all the errors to the fine solution to get our final multigrid result. We add the coarse to the medium curve, which gives us this blue-greenish intermediate result I've mentioned before. And then we add the fine curve on top of it, which results in our final multigrid solution. So, we haven't really talked about the red curve yet. This is the result of three pure Jacobi iterations on the initial system. Since we also did three separate Jacobi iterations during our multigrid method, this curve is basically here to demonstrate that multigrid does a much better job than pure Jacobi method with the same number of iterations. For any more information, the commented version of this code is available as a download in the description. I wrote it in Octave, but I think there's nothing complicated in there, so it should run on MATLAB as well without any changes. So yeah, that's it for this video. Please give me a thumbs up if it was helpful, And if you have any specific questions left after looking through the commented code, just drop me a comment on this video and I will do my best to answer it. Thanks for watching and have a good day.